Can I place an order to go, please?
Name?
David.
Okay.
Could I just get two bacon, egg, and cheeses on an everything bagel?
Toasted?
Yes, please.
Okay.
And yeah, that's it.
Okay, see you in a couple minutes.
All right, thank you. The place I just went to is called Hot Bagels and More, right? It's literally right across the street from Dunkin' Donuts, where I would normally get a bacon, egg, and cheese. Then I realized, wow, like, there's this place that has literally gourmet-level bagels, so I'm gonna go there instead. Here, there, I got two of them, plus an iced tea. Just look how nice this is. This is literally the definition of a five-star bacon, egg, and cheese. Like, it makes a Dunkin' Donuts bagel seem like they're from, like, a cooking set from Toys R Us, So my body weight's pretty low right now, as you guys could probably tell from like my last few Instagram posts, if you follow me on Instagram, that I'm pretty lean right now. And the reason for that is because when I travel, just getting enough calories is extremely difficult. And plus, I was staying at Lainey's and Lex's house, and like everything there is super macro friendly, meaning like low in calories, low in fat. So and, like, super satiating as well. So it was like tough for me to like get a surplus there. But I'm here for like 3 or 4 days, I believe, since I came back, and I'm still like, getting in the groove to my diet again. I'm still trying to push over that consistently over like 192, 193 in the morning. Like, as you guys saw, this is gonna be my first meal today. Two bacon, egg, and cheese, and that Snapple, and pretty sure I have to hit legs today. So almost like 6 hours later, right? Finished one of my bagels. I have one more to go. Appetite's just horrific right now, right? But as I'm eating these bagels, I'm actually watching this show, right? It's called Power, and a few people have told me about the show. I remember when I was in the Gymshark offices, Dan Knight, he was like really pushing the show to me. Like, a few other people tell me to watch the show. And actually, someone at Body Power came up to me, right? And they were literally telling me, like, you need to watch the show. So I'm on the second episode right now. And from what I see so far, it's really, really, really good. And like, I'm really excited to pretty much just like power watch this entire show. So if you guys are in need of a show, definitely check out Power. It's 8 o'clock. That's all I've eaten so far. I haven't eaten much the past few days, so I'm gonna stem up pretty heavy right now. Well, not that heavy. There's just two little scoops of ESP in here. I'm gonna go to the gym. Supposed to do legs today, but I really don't wanna do legs. I was supposed to do legs yesterday, but I ended up doing like another like upper body push and pull day. I think today I might do some deadlifts. If deadlifts don't feel that good, I'll do some squats, and worst comes to worst, I'll just get a full upper body pump. And yeah, after that, I'm gonna take a day off, and I'm gonna finally start the program again. The 3 week cycle that keeps going on and on and on. I was running that before I actually left for the UK, and I was doing very, very well on it, and came back, and I'm slowly gonna transition back into that. So yeah, today's gonna be my last fun day. So I just remembered what came in the mail like a few days ago, right? Wasn't able to use it up until today, like properly, right? So here you go. They're these clips. I forget what they called. I wanna say like Achilleo clips, something like that. I pretty much did like 3 minutes worth of research, got the best clips I could find. I ordered it from ropefitness.com, so. Woo! That's Eggy Kid right there. He's an old friend of mine. Eggy, I actually saw him in Dylan's video. Turns out he's a rapper as well, so later on we're gonna play some of his tunes. But anyway, right here, these clips, they're made out of metal. These are steel fucking clips, no plastic. This is not messing around, right? So you put it in and then you clamp it down. And I brought it to the gym the other day for a push day, just to like play with him, obviously. And even with it wide open, I could not get it on the bar. I would have to push so hard, so it wasn't worth it. So I'm pretty much only gonna use these for deadlifts, because there's not that much travel room for this clip to go, because there's so many like plates loaded on the bar. And these are extremely important on deadlifts, because you guys saw my last PR, 635, all the weight fell off. So that's sloppy, unacceptable. We can't have that, so we got these. Thank you.
So as you guys just saw, one for a YOLO 6.55. That would have been a 20 PR from a 20 pound PR from last time, and put the place in the bar, started pulling, and just did not come off the ground. I don't really have any excuse other than was not strong enough to pull today. So
now what are you about to do?
Nothing.
What?
Nothing.
You're about to do a 335 on the bench right here?
335? 335?
For a Spoto? Eric Spoto would be proud. Too bad he's not the world record bench anymore. Krill Scratch Alive. Something like that. 638 pause.
Pause?
Fucking, yeah, all like competition powerlifting benches have to be paused.
How long do they have to hold it?
It's like kind of like half a second or a second, but they lower it to their chest and they wait for the command to press up.
They tell them when to push
it. Yeah, it kind of like fucks people up, but
that's
what happened.
I used to like sit there and wait for like a second.
Yeah, it's fucked up, right? This one's for Eric. Let's see if that Spoto is the correct distance. That's good. That's solid. So I think I like very mildly. What are you cheesing at, Dante?
I'm looking at me.
You're cheesing at. I'm about to talk about my glutes.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not a big deal. So I think I very mildly like strained my left glute a little bit, like on that max attempt. I don't think it's anything serious. We'll probably clear up in a few days, but yeah. That happened, so I can't really do any like squats or deadlifts today, so do that fun upper body pump workout.
The audacity, actually, to really think I care that you're mad at me. Well, you took a knife and put it in the back of me. Love like a Shakespeare tragedy. The alchemy of you and me. Mix an M-A-K. Catastrophe, you're the OG in apologies. You're out at the end and it's last to me. And now you're out running your mouth, talking your shit so loud. Do yourself a favor, turn it down, please. I'ma let them know what you're about. Tell me, do you like the taste of the medicine that you made? Did it feel big, you're the blame.
Got done training, and like I said, today wasn't really anything special because not really following a strict regimen. I'm waiting to get like over like a certain body weight, like around 190, and actually start being full again and have energy so I could go into like the program that I normally run and do my big heavy compound lifts. Because like I said, ever since I got back from the UK, just some kind of messing around, and I think either tomorrow or the day after I'm finally gonna start the program, which is gonna start off with legs, of course, and then I'm just gonna run it all the way through. So yeah, just came in today. Deadlifts were feeling really good. I put on 135 and I just pulled it a few times, like, yep, I'm gonna go for someone on deadlift. failed 6:55, which would have been the 20-pound PR. Like, I feel like I'm repeating myself because I said all this earlier in the video. But yeah, after that, I did just a bunch of accessories. And the reason that I just don't, the reason I don't go straight into like my program when I'm not, okay, the reason I didn't go straight into my program today, even though I wasn't in the gym, was because it's big, heavy compound lifts, like squats and deadlifts and stuff. And if you're not in a caloric surplus, if you're not eating enough food, it's just so much more difficult. And for me, it's kind of, in a way, counterproductive because I'm not going to be able to achieve progressive overload. And that's what, that's pretty much the whole goal of training. The only benefit really would be keeping my motor pathways. But I hit like a few squats yesterday just with like 225, 315. So it's not like I'm going to forget like the squat pattern. But yeah, pretty decent workout. Got a good pump. And actually right now, I'm at a place called Island Suntan. And yeah, I'm pretty much about to go lay in a tanning bed. And I pretty much figured out the secret to life, right? If you just want to be a happy person and just improve the quality of your life like tenfold, just get a tan. It just, it makes everything so much better. It adds like 10 to 15 pounds of muscle. Like when you like take a picture, right, then you increase the structure on Instagram. That's what a tan does to you in real life. So it's pretty nice. One thing that I found pretty weird is that people like to say like tanning beds are horrific for you, and they're the same type of people that just go out in the sun for like 10 hours and just get burned. Now the ultraviolet rays when it comes to tanning are much, much stronger like in the tanning bed opposed to the sun, of course, but it all boils down to pretty much time under like either the sun or the tanning bed. So if you're just going in, I mean, the benefit of a tanning bed, right, even though the radiation is so much more, is that you could choose exactly how much tan you want. You could, like, when I say how much tan you want, I mean how long you're going to be under there for. So if you're just there for like 3 or 4 minutes, you're not really going to get that much damage whatsoever, like hardly any damage at all. But when you're out in the sun, you're not out in the sun most of the time just to solely be out in the sun and tan, unless of course you're tanning and stuff. Normally you're at the beach or hanging out outside. It's so much easier to get burned, even though there's much less radiation. So it all boils down to, like I said, how long you're under the radiation. So I'm gonna go in, I don't do this for long at all. I do like 3 to 6 minutes, like 6 minutes max. You know, I'm gonna do 5. So yeah, I'm just getting a tan. That's all I'm gonna say. God, Dante, you just scared the shit out of me. I literally had enough time to literally get scared, horrified, click record on my camera, and continue my genuine reaction of being fucking terrified. That's how much you just creeped up on me. And my battery's at 1%. Were you just, wait, is Christian not home? Whose car is that?
Oh, it's a Mercedes.
Since when the fuck? Wait, they're like not parked on our thing. So you were just, oh shit. I was tanning while you were just like sitting there?
I wasn't there long, I just got there. Me and...
Oh, Dante, let's go inside. Dante, what's it called? Are you ready for this?
Ready for what?
Are you ready for this, right?
Yeah.
All right, so here's the deal, right? As you know, as you guys probably know, Gymshark is releasing a bunch of products, right? One of the products they recently released was just like hats, right? And you can't just not wear a hat your entire life and just fucking start wearing hats. Like, it does, like, you can't just, like, show up to, like, the fucking mall or, like, show up to hang out with your friends, like, wearing a fucking hat if you've never worn a hat before. Like, it doesn't work that way, right? And I don't know how to finesse my way into transition into wearing hats, so I can't really wear them. But Dante over here, you're a hat guy, right, Dante?
Yes, sir.
You're a hat guy. So I'm going to find a Gymshark hat somewhere in here. It's in this house, and we're going to give Dante this hat.
It's fresh. That's fresh.
It's weird, like the hat's made for like XL heads. Like, it's like you gotta like tighten like the thing up in the back.
No, it's small right now. It's
right now it's small because, yeah, when we tried it on, we made it small. It is.
It's almost got a tiny head, bro.
Shit, Dante. These hats either just came out or been out for a while. I don't know, because Gymshark doesn't send me hats because they damn well know I'm not a fucking hat guy.
I gotta decide between going forwards or backwards. It's a big decision.
Why? One day forward, the other day backward.
Sometimes some hats look better forward, and sometimes
really better backwards. See, these are things that I don't know. I'm glad I'm learning, though. Maybe one day I'll write an ebook about how to finesse your way into wearing hats.
Ooh, I like it backwards.
Ooh.
That's fresh.
Ooh. God damn.
I wear it all the time now.
You look happy. No pre-workout leg day and the gym just ends up being closed?
The fucking gym was closed and I literally go to the gym, right? I'm already depressed. I'm like thinking to myself, oh, I have to hit a depressed leg day. I come into Attilus. I literally had my right shoe and right knee sleeve on. I start putting my other knee sleeve on. The guy comes up. He's like, oh, we're closing. You got 10 minutes.
Oh.
And I just threw a fit.
Like, and it literally takes you like
10 minutes to put on one of your shoes and one of your knee sleeves.
I started throwing all my shit all over the place.
Causing a big ruckus, causing a scene. Now he's going to try to finesse his way into Island tonight.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm low-key just going to go home and cry.
You know how easy it... What would Greg Plitt do right now? It's fucking legs, right?
Right now, Greg Plitt, realistically, Greg Plitt would go to the gym. No, because think about it. Right now, Greg Plitt, right, he would walk 15 miles to the gym while listening to, like, just Phantom of the Opera and just enjoy it. Go in there, literally make sure the gym stays open for him and he hit his legs.
Greg Plitt was such a motivation for me, like, to the point where, like, literally, my freshman year, I was so sleep deprived all the time because I played ice hockey and I would have to drive to practice multiple times a week, hours away, and just waking up super early because I have to take the bus to school and the bus comes like an hour before school actually starts. So I was just lack of sleep 24/7. I didn't use pre-workouts back then because I was terrified of them. It's like Friday night, right? Everyone's chilling, partying, having a good fucking time, right? I'll come back from school with all these essays and I gotta like bullshit my way through and all this homework. But you know what? It's hailing outside. It's pouring rain bad. It's terrible. And I literally just take my bike and I muscle my way all the way to the gym. And I do a huge bro leg workout with drop sets on the hack squat, the leg press, the front squat, the back squat, the fucking high low bar, every single type of squat. Then I just come home like an honest man.
Dude, back in the day when we were in high school, I used to ride my bike during a tornado.
Right?
There'd literally be a tornado, like I'll like gauge the tornado, where it's coming, like I'll ride like 100 feet behind me. I'll go into the gym, dude. This shit was cool. I used to literally go ride to the gym at 11:30 at night, the day before school, ride, get home at 4, wake up at 7.
God. The dedication levels back in the day were off the charts. Simply off the charts.